Hello YouTube, how's it going? This is Anthony Gray, welcome to Grayscale. We're going to try something a little different today. It'd be a floral, but this time we'll do it in black and white. Okay? Something you've more than likely never really seen much of before. As you can see, it's one of my paintings. I had extra paint, and I did the acrylic paint water pour. And with this, I just wiped it real fast and just let it drip straight down, let it fade, everything on its own. I didn't do anything else to it. It's what you see is pretty much what you get. Alright, that's all I've done to this. Okay, I sketched out where the flower will be, and I sketched out a couple of patterns in chalk where I would like to put a couple of leaves, and we're just gonna go from there. I'm gonna do subtleties of gray, obviously, and white mix, or black and white mix. I'm using nothing but acrylic gesso. Alright, no white paint, really, quote-unquote paint, no black paint, quote-unquote, just gesso mix, alright? And we'll just go on from there. So I'll bring the camera back in, and let's work on the leaves. I tend to, because of the positioning of the camera and me being a lefty, when I do leaves or try to show you something, the back palm of my hand blocks the way, and I apologize for that. So we're gonna try to remedy that issue. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I remember talking to you about having a medium of like some kind of water soluble gel, like KY jelly or hair gel or something like that, to put either on the board. I'm gonna do that right now with this leaf here. Okay, I'm gonna zoom in. Let me zoom this in a little bit more. I really want you to see this. Okay, so we'll concentrate on these two leaves here. All right, I'll put the gel on. Right now, you don't have to use a lot of gel. Alright, something like that. I'll do it on the other side here. Just a little gel. Okay. Even if you go above the lines in it, really doesn't matter. The more you wipe it, the more it kind of disappears on you. Alright. For this, I'm going to use a little bit of the gray gesso. Okay. And I'll start wide here. Something like that. That's about it. Now I can approach this a couple different ways. Right now I believe what I'll do is, well, let me show it to you this way first. I'll use the whole gray gesso thing. When I do the leaf, alright, I did have a framework here. The horizontal part of the brush, the flat part there. Well, here's the vanishing point, that little dot. That's your vanishing point. Okay. I will take the brush, wherever you put it, go flat, press down, and you go right towards that dot. Do another one, aim it towards the dot. A little smaller, aim straight towards the dot. Let's do it on the other side. I got a little paint left. Press, aim toward that dot. Same thing here. Aim toward the dot. Like so. That's it. Alright. Let's put the stem there. Stem from here on all the way across. Just like so. Alright. That's doing it slow. You can go faster the more you get comfortable with it. Right now I'm putting the gel into the acrylic gray paint. Okay, but what I'm going to do for this opposite, alright, what I'll do for the opposite here is I'll do the center. Okay, the gel disappeared, but that's okay. I'll go narrow and just wider here like that. Now I'm going to take a tiny bit of black, smallest bit of black. It's going to mix in with a little bit with the gray. Okay. Get some gel. I'll just put the gel right on the brush with the gray. Okay. Just a little bit. And I'm going to do the same thing. But I'm going to lift off. You're going to have to lift off because you got another color. Okay. And you do the same thing on the other side. Just like so. And you get your stem. Go right into it. Alright. Now you have two different leaves. But you see, it's more interesting with the little striations and everything. With that black mixed in it. Okay. So let's do a little bit of that. I'm just dipping into the gray and a little bit of medium. It thins it out. Okay, so let's add some interest here. Not necessarily a highlight, but I'm doing the same thing. But now the strokes aren't as long as they were before. Okay, now obviously that's a little bit lighter, but I'm going to take one side and just darken it. So maybe here. Press and just release. Press, release. Everything's still going towards the dot. Okay. Now obviously since I have such a darker side of gray, just add a little highlight while I drop the brush. When you add the highlight, I really don't want to add exactly pure white. I'll touch it up with some of this gray gesso just to obviously gray it up a little bit. Alright, and let's do it right from here. Okay, we'll do it on the other side the same way. It all still meets where the imaginary dot is. Okay. I want to highlight the vein in the center. Okay. So I'll just give it a little highlight, play with it a little bit. Even here. Just a little touch of highlight. Alright. And that's it for those two. So let's go further down. So I'm bringing the camera across the plant, and there's the other two. Right down there in this corner here. Alright. Right there. And right there. I'm putting my finger there so I can see exactly where I'm at with this. Let's do it the opposite way. Let's use black now. Okay. As the foundation color. I've got my gel into the mix. This is not really a total black, okay, because it's white and there's gray still mixed in it, but I got the gel in it. But it's going to be obviously a lot darker than what you see up here. This time, go thick, turn around, and thin it right out. I'll show it to you on this one up here. Start out flat, go slow. If you have to, almost like a kite shape, something like that. Okay, I'm gonna still use that dark mix. All right, it's the same premise as before. Only thing is getting a little more gel. Only thing is that I'm just using a darker color. Okay, not a true black. It's still kind of gray. All right, and we're gonna do the same thing. Brush pressing against. And you go towards the imaginary line that it just disappears there. And we'll do the same thing on the other side. Actually, I want that a little bit larger. Just like that. And we'll come around. Well, let me get some more dark here. We're going to come around. Oh, well, actually, this one would swing that way. This one would actually loop. and go the another direction like that. Okay. Now I'm going to take gray. I already have black on the brush, so I'm just going to take the gray, dip it into some medium. Now I'm not putting it into the black because I want a kind of a lighter highlight color. All right, give me some more medium because I got a feel that on my brush it moves pretty slick. If it moves slick on the paper, it'll move slick here on the canvas too. Okay. There. And we're going to do the same thing. But when you push off sooner than you did your first run. Your first pass through. Something like that. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Like so. Okay. And we're going to lighten up that center just a bit. I'll do it right there too, just a little tad. Going back into the gray, gesso. Okay. A little bit of the medium. And we're going to do the same thing with this guy here. Remember where that dot would be. Oh, approximately right there. For that guy. Alright. And we're going to do it again. You're going to press and go right in and disappear. Press. And you're going to do it on the other side. Just press, press, and press. Let's give it a little highlight. I still got a little bit of gray on my brush, so it won't be it won't totally be white. Okay. Let's do it here from the bottom. Same premise. Just like that. Okay. Obviously, I want the vein to kind of show a little bit. Same thing here. Just a little. I'm going to have to go back up here because I realized I just made a mistake. You see how the bright is on the one side here? It's not going up above. You see the shine is on the opposite ends? Let's not have that. Let's put the bright. It's getting a little more bright paint here. A little more gel. Let's put that bright edge on this side. Right here. Just like so. And we're going to darken that other spot. I'm going to reach over you here. I'm just taking the brush, taking the paint off the brush, getting some more gel, because I do have plenty of this dark gray. And we're going to darken it in from up here. Darken it from the top. I might want that a little bit darker than that. So I'm going into straight black. There. And we're going to do the same thing here. I got to have it match on one side. Okay. But something like that. That's all it takes. Alright. So, let's zoom up for a second. Put the camera downward. You'll see what I'm talking about here. There. Alright. But it's not too bad. A little brighter up here. Not as bright down here. Okay. Now I still got a little of black on my brush. And that's fine. Right now I'm going to do a little double loading. I'm using gray on one side. Maybe some black on the other. Okay. And get some medium. I still want this to flow smoothly. Let's get some of the long branches playing around in here. So, not branches, but long leaves. The dark is up on top. So you're going to make sure when you do this leaf, the dark is on the top. Something like that. Okay, I'm getting some more medium. Gotta find where my dark and light is. And let's do another one. Let's make it a little, where are you? Make it a little bit longer. Let's zoom you in a little bit so you can see exactly what I'm doing. Like I said, I had a bad habit of not having the, had my hand in the way. So let me show you. Come from here. Spread. And come down. You can wiggle a little bit. Something like that. All right. Bring that out. Okay. More gray, touch of black, mix it right in together. Cause I just see this, the separation between these two is not so jarring. Okay, they just blend right into each other. Okay. I want to put another one down here. Maybe it's coming from here. Come down. Just like that. And have it curl in. Okay. Let's do another one because a short one. A little baby one right there. Okay. You know what? I like the way that looks. So let's do another one. A little baby right there. You know what? I like that. Baby right there.
I just think it looks cool. One of those. Let's zoom out. Let's zoom out.
Okay. I'll show you how that was done. Again, no problem. Let's go from this side. Let's do it from the top. Remember, you want your darkness go up top, lighter on the bottom. So, all I did, let's get some medium. Make sure this goes pretty smoothly here. Take the flat edge of the brush, press down. Go across, don't be so scared to do it, and the light side is on the bottom, and just go back up again. Okay, I want more of a trailing point there. Make sure you have a nice little point going somewhere with this. Okay, flatten that out, come up, curl like so. Let's do another one. I just can't have like one hanging around there by itself. So we're going to do another one, branching right off. Have it go straight down. Curl a little bit. These guys are a little bit in the back. If I choose to put something in front of those, obviously it'd be brighter and it'd stick out more. Alright. But that's basically how that goes. Just like that. Alright. Let's put some of the wiggle leaves in there. Okay. I thought about rinsing off the brush, but I really don't have to. I got the gray, I got white, just plopping it in there and taking the black, maybe in the corner. But I want it pretty mottled up, so there's not one real predominant color. Okay, let's, we're going to have a nice little jumble of leaves coming. Let's go right in front of these guys. Okay. We're going to go here. Let's go right in the front. And a little F curl down there. Since I got it going from that top part. Okay, well, we're going to concentrate on the top up here. Alright, excuse me. What I'm going to do is take this flat edge. Wherever you got the direction of the flat edge, we're going to put it right here, right into the leaf itself. I don't want to touch the actual vein itself, okay? Don't want to touch the vein itself. Alright. Go a little bit past there. Press down. Wiggle. Go back up. Don't leave the paper. Give it a little tip, little point. Okay. Let's do it again. Let's do it from this side here. Angle downward. Press down. You're going to wiggle. Come back up. Give a little point. Like that. That's all you need to do. I want them a little brighter. So I'm going to dab into a little white, a little bit of gray.
Still got black in there, but I just wanted to stick out a little more to bring these little petals out in front of the leaves here, like so. I just want to brighten it up a little bit. Let's do another one, probably on top of this one. I'm going a little further out, just like that, and just keep going. I'm turning the brush around. I'm going the other side now. Alright, I don't went too fast for you. There I am. I'm right around there. And we're going to just keep doing it. I'm going to touch a little more white. I still want a little tad brighter. Okay, let's overlap this one here. Come on that way. And we're going to do the same thing here. Overlap. You want them to kind of not be little tin soldiers all in a row. Don't do that. Don't be scared to overlap your leaves, okay? And let's put one right here. Wiggle, straight, get that little peak out there. That guy right there. I'll do it again because you missed it. I tend to go too fast. All right. Press, wiggle, up, and out. Press, wiggle, up. Like so. Let's brighten some of those up. I'm going to add a little white because they kind of blend too much. I want a little separation there. Something like that. Okay. And since I want a little separation there, let's darken, let's lighten up that vein right in here. So, okay, now if they're hidden too far behind the other leaf, I'll show you here. Let's go back up. Now that little batch of leaves that I like so much, as you see, is gone. Okay, but that's fine. We can also correct that. Let's bring that out a little bit. Okay, I kind of like the way that presented itself. I like the way it looked. So what I'll do, let's make a lighter representation of what I had before. Just the slightest touch of black, but more of the white and gray. Alright. A little bit of gel. Okay. I really did like the way they look. I don't tend to have them here. I really don't want to really clutter up anything. So I might just do a couple. Right in here. Can you see it? You can still see it. Now, I'm going to turn my brush around. Like that. Come down. Like that. Do another one. Curve. Come down. I'm going to do another one. Let me get some more gel. You got to have it really smooth. Gonna come flowing right over this leaf, down right over that leaf. So you need something brighter to do that. All right so now we got a brighter batch coming right down over the leaf. Okay, I might want to put one somewhere around there. I'm gonna brighten it up just a little bit. Just that corner. I'm using Jessel, so it's a little thinner than with the paint I would normally use. Okay, let's put one just coming across the other ones. Something like that. Get the point kind of straight. A nice little tip. And let's keep going. Let's go here. Right off the page. Maybe one. Let's do one around here. Probably coming up here. Let's watch this. Come up. Get wide. Stop. Get wide. Going across. Now I need obviously more white, more gray, and more of the gesso. Because I want that to be a little smoother than what I did. Around, come, stop. Gonna continue around. And let's have it curve right on off the page. Like so. I want a little more of a separation. That one, it's there, but it doesn't have anything really to, there we go. Add a little character to it. There. Something like that. Then we'll just add another one. He'll just come branch off. Just like that. Alright. He's up there. So let's draw this back a little bit. You'll see the total thing there. Okay. Now, obviously, in black and white, but you got different shades and different tones going all over the place. Okay, so that's pretty cool. Let's wipe off the brush. Get my little towel here. Let us maybe. You know what? Let's try something really, really light. I'm gonna do a half a leaf. At least I can just show you how it's done anyway. I got the gel out right now on my brush. It's going back and forth on the plain piece of the paper. Just the slightest tip of black. Only on the corner. Follow me? Only on the corner. Now watch what I'm gonna do. Okay. Right across here. I'm going to get a little stroke going, just like that, just in a point. Now I'm going to rub more of clear gel in black. That's it. That is all. Okay. And I'll do it from around this point here. Watch what I'm going to do. It's going to get heavier toward the top. Okay. That's a little more black on the tip. On the corner, rather. When I say tip, I mean the corner. I'm adding the gel, so it's nothing but dark, and then the gel. Something like that. Just like that. Okay. That's more gel than paint. Got me? Add a little more paint. But it's still got the clear gel. If you happen to get too much gel on one side, you just take it right off. That's all you got to do. You take it, just take it right off. Let's do it on the other side. It's more gel than paint. Okay. Just like that. I just wanted to put it in there. Just to do it. Okay, that's all. No more. This is to show you it can be done. I'm wiping, cleaning off the brush. And basically, I'm using the same brush. It's a 3/4 inch brush. Okay. I tend to use brushes that are conducive to the size of the paper. This is obviously 11 by 15 paper. Okay. If I want to put some smaller ones in there, we'll do that a little bit later, if I choose to do so. Alright. I'm going to start with gray for the flower itself. Nothing but pure gray. Gesso. Right in here. Okay. And that'll be my little foundation color. Just the gray gesso. Going outward. So all I'm doing is just using the gray gesso. This is it. Just like that. Follow your rule. Just that simple. Just like that. Alright. Now, all in where you want to put the cup. Okay. Of the the rose or poppy or whatever. I'll use black mixed in with the gray. It's still gonna come out black. Okay, let's do lower circle right in here, but you're gonna just fade it out. Fade it right on out. Something like that. No more, a little less. Just like that. A little more here on the top. But yeah, pretty much like that. Let's go do something the same thing but on the bottom here. More of a curve. Come back up. And even with this, see the direction of the strokes. Just like that. No more, no less. Okay. If you want to get it out towards the edge more, that's cool too. The important part is that cup in there. Right in there. Okay. This is where your strokes will become pretty important. Let's zoom in. Right about around there, something like that. Alright. Now, I'm rinsing off. Off my brush. I would like to have this I'll mix some white and some gray. I'll mix plenty of it. The white I will use with nothing but pure highlight, just the corner of it in black, but I still want to maintain a lot of this medium gray tone. Make sure you get yourself plenty of it. Put plenty of medium in there also, okay, because you're going to be coming back to that kind of often. All right, and just remember your strokes when it comes to doing something like this. So let's say here the leaves, the petals will be facing you. Here they're out, but they're going into the bowl itself. Here's your cup. The black in here is the bowl. All in there is the bowl going in a circle. You got me. This is going in a circle. Okay. I got plenty of paint on here. And what I'm going to do is start probably from this little curve. Curve, and you go in. When you go in, you're going to lift up. All right, I will usually have a little guide here, but let's just do it. Oh well, let me just show you. See a little dot right there? Everybody's going to meet at the dot. Okay, where they're coming from, this side, you're coming from this side, everybody's meeting at the dot. All right, so with that said, maybe another curve, go towards the dot. Another curve, towards the dot. Towards the dot. Towards the dot. Now that one is obviously straight up and down. You're going to start to curve again, but in the other direction, towards that dot. Just like so. That's it. Just like you see. Right towards that dot. Okay. Let's do a row of them in the inside. Now the inside might be slightly darker. Slightly. Do it just so you don't get confused, really. Just slightly darker. Okay, let me get some more gel. Putting it right into the paint. Alright. And we're going to do the same direction. But let's go halfway. Let's go right from here. Go up here like that. You're going to go around. And you're going to meet that guy. Just like that. Okay, let's maybe go a tad bit darker. We're going to do the other side. Only reason why I'm doing it is just for separation's sake. Okay, now you have the light one on the outside. You got a medium in the inside. You're going to do another one. It's going to come around. Here's that curve. Okay. Now, can you tell? Can you see it now? Light, medium, dark. Got me?
Alright. Let's do something a little bit out here. Out here, let's still stick with the medium type of color. Okay, get some more gel. Up around here. Let's just have it like, I'll have to paint it out for you. It's going to meet somewhere around in here and go in. We're still meeting toward the dot. So, meet toward that dot. This is still your bowl here. Okay, so now you have your flower. You got the ones here, the medium. Alright, so let me highlight those so you don't get too confused. Okay, because this one's on the outside of the petals. So let's just highlight it, pure white. Okay, we're going to come on the outside, just like so. Getting more pure white. Put a little medium in that brush, just pure white, just doing the highlight back there. Okay, let's do a little bit of highlight in here, like so. Want to keep it moving. Number pure highlight, and we'll stagger it a little bit. And coming out, coming out, coming out, just like that. Let me put this outside one here, so I can give you a little separation of that bowl in there. That bowl, top of the bowl, do it to one of a couple ways. I still want the darkness, so what I'll do is I'll just do a couple of taps here, white on one side, then on the other. Something like that. Okay. So that lets you know that darker in the inside. Maybe you can play around just a little bit, not too much. You still want to maintain it being a little bit darker in there. But something like that. Now that I've did that, now you can see you got the petals streaking around here. Overlap a little bit, just like that. I don't have to really add too much really to that. You already can tell it's looping around on the outside here. Maybe I might want to just play around with that one and put just like that. And maybe another wild curl in there.
There.
Okay. Once you get used to the stroke, okay, and the direction you want your petals, It gets easier. Okay. Coming toward us, I want it to be a little dusky, a little darker. Alright. So what I'm going to do is get my face out of your view. Get some more gel. Let's say I still want to keep that bowl there. Okay. From this point, I'm going to curve it. Here, and I'll stop right there. That's the bottom.
That will be your bottom right there.
The top. Now, the bottom. Here's that dot again. Your horizon has now changed.
Okay.
Your dot will be here. So now, all points lead to that dot on the bottom. So you're going to have a petal flaring out and aiming this way. Same thing here. Flares out, aims that way. Okay, and it follows that dot. Just like that. Okay, of course you don't see no separation because it's all the same color. Not for long. I'm just tipping in a little bit of white
Make sure my hand's not in the way. You can see the strokes. Turn the brush over. And do it again. Just like that. Okay. Now what I didn't do was add a curve in that. But that can also be corrected. Alright. I want to add a curve because it just looks way too straight. Okay. Well, you know what? I can also cover that. I'm going to show you how right now. Watch this. I'm going to go... Yeah, you can. It's perfect. I'm going to go around in that circle. Now, in doing that, let's make it thick around here, around there. You're going to continue that curve. All right. Just getting a little more dark. Get some more gel. Because I don't like how straight that is. So to get the curve, all right, I want to really come in here and go in that direction. I'm going to have to lighten it up so you can actually see the stroke. Like that. But you're going to come down. Come down. And you're going to come from the top in this direction. Go down. Go down. All right. I have to really brighten it up so you can see exactly where I'm at. And I'm not going to brighten the whole thing. I'll just do one of these numbers. You're going to give it a push. 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 Coming right above. There. Now, let's pull back and you'll see what I'm talking about. You see how that covered all that up? Okay. Cover up your insecurities. So that's not too bad. And let me wipe off my brush. Got too much paint on it. Let's say I want to highlight an edge. Like so. That's all you need. No more, no less. See that? Okay, even with the little fingernail piece in there. Scratch. Just like that. Okay. You can still see the separation of the rows of petals. All in a stroke. Alright. And it's in black and white. Alright. Let's play around with this stuff here on the outside. Outside will be a little bit lighter. I'm just playing with the shades of gray with the gel. Okay. That's all I'm doing. Now, a little bit lighter up around here. You're going to go with the curve. I'm going to start a little bit beyond this mark. Press. And just let it go. And you overlap. Alright. I'm going to turn it inward. I don't want the whole thing looping around. So let's go with a sharp turn inward. Okay. I'm going to brighten that up on the top there. Something like that. Well, might as well. I done did it now. Something like that. But now I'm going to take some dark because I want that a little darker in there. And I can always lighten it and relighten it up if it's too dark. Something like that. And maybe do the same thing here. Just add a little variation. Go back to my white. A little more of the gel. Okay, let's say that I want it coming, a leaf coming right out here, like so. Now your vantage point is still back up in here. Alright, so you're going to, even if you have to stagger it a little bit, it's okay. Just like that. And make it just disappear. Okay, sort of like that. I might want to maybe darken in the middle a little bit, just to add a little variance, just a little different here. And just like that. See, they don't all have to be uniform in the same size, but it's still all vanishing toward that point. I can keep layering and layering and layering and layering and layering forever if that was, you know, if I chose to do that, if I decided to do that. Okay. Now I'm going to add a nice little ruffle, a little edge to it on that corner. All right about here. Just a little push. A little push. A little push. Okay. And up here, maybe right up in there. And have it come right around. Like so. Okay. Flower's just about done. Okay. So I'll add, with all of this, I'll still add the leaf for this thing. Okay. Now, where I would put them, rinsing off the brush, where I would, got plenty of paint on here. Where I would put them, the leaf themselves, to make it stick out, I would use nothing but black and then use gray and the highlight. Okay. I have plenty of black on here. And black is such an incredibly stark, deep color. So let's put maybe one in here. Have it thick, have it thin, right up around there. Okay. Nothing but pure black gesso. No medium, no nothing. Alright. And we're going to have the leaf go right in, right in, right in. Do it on the other side. Like so. That's leaf number one. Okay. Let's do leaf number two. A little further away. Out. Come out. Right around in here. Okay. Try to get that tip to a point. Same direction, same type of leaf. Right, just put it right in there. And same thing here. Maybe have one even come out further. Okay, like that. I'm going to keep going. I kind of want these leaves to be out there a little bit. Let's put a big one right here. Let's have it come out, out, curve down. Nothing but pure black. Push, lift away. Push, lift away. Push, lift away. Same thing on the other side. Just a little bit closer. Push, lift away. Push, lift away. Remember your point's back here. Just like that. Alright. No more, no less. Why draw a center line? You're not going to see it anyway. Alright, I might even have one, yeah, because it's dark, I have one farting around, right up around here. Cover that other leaf right up, it doesn't matter, so what? And come to a point right up in there. Okay, so we're going to do it again. Do it again and again, one more. Okay, of course you're not going to see it because I zoomed in a little too much, but that's okay. When I lighten up that one, I'll bring it back up. Okay, so now that I've did the for the leaves, I'm going into my white, okay, which is now not white anymore because I did not erase the black, but that's okay. I can always get more. But it's a very deep, very deep gray. Okay. When I put it against this dark black, you'll see. It is a deep gray. Okay. Let's have it gray on the top. Push, but not as far. Not as far. But now you see how light it actually is compared to nothing but pitch black. Okay. Oh, no, you can't, because I just went up there and did everything I told I wasn't going to do. Let's go back up here. I'll make it lighter so you can actually see what I messed up. I'm going to go over the same stroke again, but not as heavy. Like that. And you can put the little vein in there if you want. Something like that. Okay. I'm going to do the rest the same way. Oh, you can't see that. I'm sorry. Go back down here. All in the same direction. Even the one on the other side here. Same stroke, same direction. Just like that. I'm going to wipe the brush off. Believe it or not, I don't believe I have any white. I just killed it with that black. I have to wash this brush. Okay. I have my zinc white here. It's just closest to me. My other one is, I'd have to really cross the camera to get it, and I really don't want to do that. So I'll use my very weak looking zinc white, and I'll just do the highlight for the zinc. Nothing but zinc white. I'll put a little bit of medium in it. Get it flow a little bit. Just like so. Highlight will be on the bottom. Let's go here first.
No, let's put the camera up there first.
Alright. Like so. Right on the edge here. Put that just like that. Kind of get in there, just like so. Let's do the.
Well, you gotta come downward to see it. Let's keep it right there.
Let's do the rest of the center. Right along in here. No separation on the brush, please. A little bit longer there. Okay. More gel. Definitely more gel. More gel, much more white. And we go back to highlighting on the bottom. Something like that. Same thing here. Press, pull away. Gently. Lift, pull away. Same thing in here. Press, gently lift, pull away. Same direction. Like so.
Okay. Let's pull back. Okay. Should be able to see that if I pull in a little bit. Like so. Alright. Now you can see the whole deal in black and white. Okay,
it's the whole thing. I can add, I'm going to add a few of those anyway. Might as well. It adds a little interest to the picture. I didn't surround the flower with a whole bunch of dark. I don't think I need it. Okay, but I am going to put some little tendrils in here and there. And maybe even a rosebud. I don't, for this, I don't need to dip in the medium. All I need really is water and this thin paint. And we can have a little,
let's bring it in a little bit.
We can have little tendrils coming, like looping around the plant here, underneath, come on around and down. Definitely got to water up the highlighter brush. You need the ink at a very the paint at an inky consistency. Keep going down. We'll have it curl right around here. All right, getting plenty of water, put it right into the paint. Get it as easy to flow as you possibly can. Let's have one loop around, come behind this guy, and loop around. Now, it's obviously you're gonna need more paint, more pure paint, to have it show if it's too light, or you got your curls, something like that. Okay, let's pull back a little bit. You can see it hanging around down there. All right, let's go back into the water, add some more. Look at the time here. Yeah, we got a little time. Oh, maybe we'll add one right in here. Here comes the curls and curls and curls and curls up behind. He comes snaking around. Big one. Curls around the plant. Just snaking around just like that. Okay. A lot of it adds to the interest of the painting. Okay. That's all. Trying to think, maybe I have another one dangling somewhere. Don't know yet. We'll see. I just want to get the little separation there. The little loops. Everything adds a little bit of character. Okay. Helps the paint to flow along. The picture to flow along a little bit. No double veins, please. No double veins. If that vein appears to be too thick, easy remedy to that too. Dip into some black and you can thin it right out. Okay. It dries up and you'll never know. Okay. As a matter of fact, come to think of it, now that I have this black ink on here, well, why not? Why not? Put some dark ones in here somewhere. Just squirreling around. Maybe one branches off here. Need more water. One branches off. Come on down in here. Something like that. Just come right off the page. Why not? Come down this way. Branches off. Loops around. Can you guys see that down there? He comes off the page. This one here comes, loops around. Let's give him a curl right here. Just like that. I haven't even thought about that. Instead of, you know, I don't have none of different colors, so just use the opposite color. Let's have one actually coming right down off the page, around the leaf, around that leaf. Comes around the white vein, comes back up in the back of the leaf here. Now let's have him go back of that leaf. Let's have him curl around like so. Nice little tight curl right there at that end. Alright, so he came from the top of the page up around here. Alright, I don't want to keep it really too busy with all of that. And while I got the black ink loose and flowing around, I might as well just put my name here. This is just about done. I just wanted to slow it down a little and show you the strokes. There. And all that good stuff. And maybe if I do another video, live video, I'll just give this one away. Who knows? All depends how I feel. But I'm pretty sure I probably will. I really hope that you enjoy this little presentation and all the good stuff. And, you know, give me a write. Let me know what you think about it. I kept it at an hour. If I don't tend to speed up anything, and I don't think I will. Just let me know, like I say, what you think. And, I wanted to show you a bud, but I guess I'll just do it some other time. I really want to keep it under an hour. So, let me know what you think, if you liked it or not, what I can do to improve it. Hopefully I got my hand out of your way. We'll find that out when I look at it. And you guys take care. Comments, leave them below. And if you want to attempt it, I would love to see it. Put it on my my Facebook page. All right. And with that said, you guys take care, and I'll catch you next time.